I will start by creating a new project. And here I will be using JDK 1.8 that I have in this directory. And next I will create three classes. A client class that will be in this package and will have a main method, and a server class that will also have a main method, and a server thread class that will extend thread. Next, let me go ahead and open up a command prompt and start by making sure that the same JDK is used as in the Eclipse project. So it is 1.8, and from the bin directory of my JDK, I will be using keytool in order to create a file on the file system, which will be a private key keystore. So what I'm saying here is I need to generate a private key, so genkey, and with a key alias of ZA store, so alias, and I need to store that information in za.store, so keystore za.store. And I'm going to use a password of just password. And let's say same thing. Yes. And I'm going to use the same password, so I'll just press enter. So let's see if that file was created. Here we go, za.store, and I'm going to copy it. So it will be generated in C users Zane Academy. And I will drop it here. And next, let me go to the client. And I will set a system properties. So javax.net.ssl.trustStore. That will be my va.store, and I'll do the same thing on the server. Next, I'll go ahead and code the server, and I set the password to be password, so I'll do system.set properties, and that will be javax.net.ssl.keyStorePassword, and I'll set it to be password. And now I need to create a secure server socket. So I'll use ssl.serverfactory.getDefault, and this static method would return a server socket factory, and I would cast it to ssl.serverSocketFactory, and then call the create server socket on it, which would return a server socket listening on this port. And the server would display this message: server up and ready for connections. And each time a new client connects, I'll have a new thread, a new server thread handling it. So server socket.accept would return a socket. And I'll pass that to the server thread. So here I'll define socket and initialize it in the constructor. And I will have a run method. And since we called the start method here, after the operating system decides to run the thread, the run method will be invoked. Next, I will create a new print writer from an existing output stream, so socket.get output stream, and auto flush here is true, so it will flush the output buffer. And next, I'll do socket.getInputStream, which would return an input stream, and I'll use that to pick up an input stream reader, and I'll use that input stream reader instance in order to pick up a buffered reader. And initially, the client will provide a username, so have system.out.println user, and BufferedReader.readline, which would be the username, is now connected to the server. And the server will append echo to each message coming from a client, and echo that message back to that client. So let me go ahead and test run the server, and then I'll go back and code the client. So here we go, server is up and ready for connections. Now for the client, I need to create a secure socket, and in order to do that, I will use the ssl.socketFactory.getDefault method. So this static method would return a socket factory, and I would cast it to ssl.socketFactory, And then I will call the createSocket method, which would return a socket. And the client will be sending messages to localhost for the purpose of this tutorial and this port. And next, I will pick up an input stream by doing socket.getInputStream and use that to pick up an input stream reader and use that input stream reader instance in order to pick up a buffered reader. And I will create a new print writer. From an output stream, so socket.get output stream, and auto flush is true, so it will flush the output buffer. And I will read user input using this buffered reader. So pass system.in to an input stream reader instance and then use that to pick up a buffered reader. And next I will ask the user for a username and pick up that username from the command prompt. And I will allow the user to continuously send messages to the server. So while always true, system.out.println, please enter a message to send to the server. And let me define message up here and read each message. So command prompt buffered reader.read line. And if the user entered quit, I will close the socket and break out of the loop. I'll also send that quit message to the server. So otherwise, I'll just go ahead and send that message and display the message coming back from the server. I'll first print out message reply from server. And this will be the echo message coming back from the server. So let me go ahead and test run the client. And let's open up another console. And let me open up actually two more consoles. And be for the server, I'll pin it down. And this will be for the first client. And let's start another client. And this will be for the second client. So let's say this is the name of this client. And let's see if we can figure out why we got this. So I had this on the server, and on the client, a trust store. Actually, on the server, I need, instead of trust store, I need key store. Okay, this should fix it. So let's save all and let's restart the server. Start one client and pin it down, and the second client. And let's say this is the first client. So this user is connected to the server, and this is the second user, and it is connected to the server. And if the first user sends this, it will be echoed back from the server with echo appended to it. And let's see if he sends another one, get the same thing. And if this client sends this, same thing. Let's quit. So let me go ahead and fix the exception that we got when I typed quit. If we go to the client, let's remove this one. Let's just close the socket. And we go ahead and start the server. The first client, and this is the second client. Quit. And quit here.